وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And there are from among people who say with their tongues, with their mouths, آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ, we believe in Allah, وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, and the last day, the day of judgment, وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ, and they are not mu'min, they are not real believers. They profess to believe, they claim to believe, they say with loud words, we believe in Allah, we believe in the hereafter, in the day of judgment, but they are not believers. Now who are they? First of all, please note, they are actually two categories who are being referred here without giving them any name. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given them any title. But as far as we can understand, there are two types of people who are being discussed here. Generally, people think that they are only munafiqeen, the hypocrites. But actually, hypocrites as well as the Jews of Medina, both are included in this category. And actually, hypocrites were also people under the influence of the Jews of Medina. They were under their influence. And they were the shayateen, people which we shall very presently read in these ayat also the word. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَاكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَحْزِئُونَ. So actually this description, as you say in English, free to whom it fits, this is a narration and it fits two groups of people of that time. Number one, the Jews. Number two, the Munafiqun, the hypocrites, who said they were Muslims, but they were not Muslims, they were not Mu'mins. Why Jews? Because here you find, يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, not بِالْرَسُولِ. Here the wordings are only that they say we believe in Allah and believe in hereafter, but not in the Rasul. We don't believe in the Messenger. At least this is not their saying. And that was the position of the Jews, because we believe in Allah. And you also believe in Allah, we also believe in Allah. You also believe in unity of Allah, we also believe in unity of Allah. You also believe in the resurrection, we also believe in the resurrection. You also believe in the hereafter, in the heaven and hell, we also believe in the hereafter, and the hell and the heaven. So we are also Mu'mins. You must accept us as believers. That was their claim. And it's very noteworthy that out of the three basic imaniyat, three basic themes of iman, only two have been mentioned. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. They are not Mu'mins. And in the same way, when we shall read the description, this fits, you know, the Munafiqun of Medina also. Because they also actually, they doubted about the messengership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We find in the Quran at different places that they said, for example, why these wars have been started, battles have been started? There's no express injunction in the Quran. لَوْلَا نُزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ. Why not a surah has been revealed in the Quran? And only on this demand of theirs, we find that Suratul Qital was revealed. Suratul Muhammad or Suratul Qital in the 26th part, which contains a very express injunction for going to war against the kuffar. So actually, they were not very sure about the messengership or prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were their claim was, Iman billah, Iman bil akhir. Actually, they took Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not very seriously. And to obey Muhammad personally, that had become most difficult for them. So these both groups are included here. If you keep in view the Ta'wilul Khas, the groups who are in the background of these ayat. But when we shall infer generally, this will fit every munafiq for all times to come. Because, as a rule, please understand, whenever there is some ideological call, when there is some revolutionary movement started based on some ideology, you will always find three types of people. There are people who accept the ideology at its face value, and then they are ready to die for it, live for it, to do whatever it demands. Then there are people who are opposed to that ideology. They oppose it clearly, openly, tooth and nail. And then there is the third group always, who want to support the ideology, but keep safe themselves. They want to play safe. They don't want to sacrifice their belongings or their lives. They want to be safe and, you know, to keep their money with them. And everything, you see, they don't want to take risks. And they want to do something good. But it should happen itself. Not that we have to do anything for it and we have to sacrifice anything for it. So these are the munafiqun, the third type of people who will always be found with every ideological movement, every revolutionary movement. People who believe it, take it at its face value, they plunge into deep waters, risking everything. People who refuse to accept and who oppose it tooth and nail, clearly. And people who are in between, la ilaha ulai wa la ilaha ulai. They are neither on that side, neither on this side. They are somewhat on this side, somewhat on that side. Meaning thereby, neither on their side, neither on this side. So these are the munafiqun. This is the third group which is being discussed here. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And they are not believers. They are not the real mu'mins. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. They try to deceive. يُخَادِعُونَ. I've added the word try. They are trying to deceive Allah and the people who believe, the real believers. Mukhada'a, this is Baba Mufa'ala, this is trying against each other. So yukhadi'un Allah wal-lazina amanu, they are trying to deceive Allah and people who believe, the mu'mins. Wama yakhda'una illa anfusahum, and they are not deceiving anybody except themselves. They are deceiving themselves. When they claim they are mu'min, they are deceiving themselves. When they think that they can please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this verbal attestation only, well, they are wrong. They are deceiving themselves. وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ, but they perceive it not. They have not the sense that they are deceiving themselves. وَلَا يَشْعُرُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. In their hearts, there is a disease. There is an ailment. That ailment is of doubt. Shak, rab, doubt. And this is actually, this shak and rab, then it goes to develop into nifaq, into hypocrisy. فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has increased them in their disease. This is the rule of Allah. This is the sunnah of Allah. This is the habit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you take to the right path, He will help you in proceeding forward on that right path. If you choose the wrong path, He will help you. Go ahead, further and further. And if you are in between, He will leave you there. It's your own choice. Imma shakiram wa imma kafura. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the choice to you, to me, to every human being. When the decision He makes, Allah makes that way easy for him to proceed further and further. All the difficulties of the right path, they are made easier for him. All the big evils of the wrong path, for those people who choose to take that wrong path for themselves, then they are made easy for him. And they go after one big evil to the another bigger evil, and then to the still bigger evil, they go forward. So actually this is the habit of Allah. فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. Allah has increased them in their disease. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And there, for them is a very painful torment. بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. On the basis of, because of the lie that they had been telling. Because they were saying we are mu'mins, they were not mu'mins. This was the lie that they were saying, they were telling.